In this program, we are going to ask user to enter array elements and then we will print this array elements into reverse order. So like the previous program, I am using array element of size 20 and n will denote the number of array elements that user wants to enter. I will be my index variable. I am asking user to enter n and then those n number of array elements I am going to accept from user. For that, I have written this loop. So for I is equal to 0, I less than equal to n. So if user has entered, let's say 5, then this for loop will execute for 5 times starting from 0 till 4. And then I'm going to accept these array elements and those values will be stored subsequently starting from array of 0, array of 1, array of 2 and so on till array of 4. So suppose user has entered 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. So in order to print in reverse direction, our second loop for printing these array elements to start from this value, that is n minus 1, because n was entered as 5. So starting from n minus 1, the loop will go till 0. So this is our second for loop to print array elements in reverse order. I am starting I from n minus 1 and the condition will be I greater than equal to 0 and I will be decremented on each iteration. And inside of printf statement, I am using slash n for printing each element on next line and the string is printed as element %d colon %d. There I am going to print first parameter as I plus 1. So I plus 1 will be replaced over here and a of I, which is array element, will be replaced over here. So output will be something like this. First value is n minus 1, so that is 4. So output in the first iteration will be element I plus 1. So current value of I is 4. So 4 plus 1, that is 5. So element 5 colon A of 4, that is 50. Then on the next line, element 4 colon 40. Again in the next iteration, element 3 colon 30. In the next iteration, element 2 colon 20. And in the final iteration, element 1 colon 10. That is the first value from our array elements. Important point to notice over here, though we have initialized array with 20, we are not utilizing this space at all. So technically, user can enter values up to 20. So that's only possibility of storing 20 array elements in this program. However, user can enter 100 also over here. But on the 21st iteration, compiler will give an error in this for loop. At the end of this course, we are going to have few lectures on few advanced topics. So in one of those topics, I'll explain you how we can declare dynamic arrays. So user can enter elements of any size that will depend on his choice.